Welcome back, everybody who wants to see what's in the box. I did an earlier video about the Ryobi bench top grinder, and took it out of the box, and we attached actually a steel wire. We took the grinding wheels off, and we attached a steel wire. That's probably the main purpose I'm going to use it for, a steel wire, and on this side I thought probably a buffing wheel. So I simplified the process already, taking it apart, making that a rather shorter video. So this comes off. We attached it earlier. We took the grindstone off, of course. And as you can see, this is the body. This is much thinner than the grindstone, of course. So Ryobi gives you a spacer. On before the flange, right here, because of that shoulder. So it means that nut that tightens everything down does not go down further than that shoulder. So to make up for the loss of thickness of these two attachments, you have that spacer. So on the other side, of course, it had the same attachment held down by three of these screws, which I took the liberty and take it off for you. And you get the picture how that works. And I did that because it's just easier to get the wheel on and off. So this is what I bought, and of course it's opened already. And it says 6-inch from Ryobi, 4 7/16 arbor. Now, this steel wheel is for 5/8 arbor width with a 1/2 inch pushing. So 1/2 inch is 8/16. This is the pushing. Make sure if you take that wheel off, this is usually in the wheel. You put that on, you change it, you pull that wheel off, the pushing is going to stay on the arbor. Take that off, otherwise, if you don't realize that's on, you're going to mush your grinding wheel down, destroying that, and then your steel wheel won't work. Anyways, this is not really the problem. So what I discovered is, you put this on, it rests on that shoulder down here. Then it says here, obviously, where do I see that? Oh yeah, right here, in the back, it says, oh yeah, it says Cecil wheel, okay, what the heck's a Cecil wheel? Denim, we understand. It's your jeans just bundled up. And then we have cushion sewn wheel. Right, so here it is. Of course, I marked them already. This is Cecil. And from what I understand, it's made from the fibers of the agave plant in the desert. And it looks kind of funny and smooth out here. But inside, it's really sort of rough. You can actually polish plastic, technical plastic with it. It's pretty cool. It lasts some time. So, and of course, denim doesn't need any explanation. It's this one. And then cushion is really for high polishing. It's really, really very soft. I don't know. I don't think they cut cushions apart, but this is just where it is. So, it's cushion. This is the cushion. this is the sisal. It's tougher, rougher. It's for actually, you can actually cut or take more material off with the sisal and polish. But then you do, probably do your final polish with the cushion. Okay, that was that. Now, we know this is a half inch, and this is a 5/8 arbor and a half inch thread. So this is recommended for 7/16. Good. Put this on. Put the flange on first. Or let's put it that way. Get the spacer on first. Supplied for the grinder, not for the polishing wheels. Get this on. Put this on. So as we can see, this hole is already not in the center. Then you have to get it down on that arbor. It still has plenty of non-threatened area left here. Now you put that second flange. And then this side actually is a righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. You really gotta tighten it. You probably can tighten it until you run out of thread there. Or not. And there you have it. So you do need a second flange, which is not included in your set. So I wanted to set up steel wheel on one side, the sisal on the other, but they give you only one flange or spacer to make up for it. And it's not running straight. As you can see. So with some luck, it's going to wear down. It's going to be round eventually. But I would wish for a little bit more consistency there. See the other ones. See, that's why I took the cover off, so I can actually grab it from both sides and pull it right off. See how the other ones go on. This one I did already. Let's try the polishing wheel. It seems like a fairly small hole. Let's see how that goes on. Just try to get the thread going. I'm just gonna hold the arbor on the other side here so I can twist that on the thread. Once it's done, I guess you just have to push it down no matter what. Put your flange on. Okay, that's it. And there you have it. You have a polishing wheel on one side. And I'm going to find some other solution to find another spacer for this side so I can actually have my steel wheel on one side and a polishing wheel on the other. It's going to be a pain switching that back and forth since I'm going to use it for polishing and brushing anyway. And that's it. That's what was in this box, fitting what was in that box. Thanks for watching.